back to climbing today, but we're going to do a different wall. We're going to go to another climbing center and hopefully get some good footage. But basically, I'm just training because I really want to get into some more outdoor climbing and that sort of stuff. So, but first, I think I'm going to go to a car boot sale. Car boot sales are the only place where you can go there without knowing what you want. And you never know what you're going to see there. It's not like you're walking into a clothes shop and you're only going to see clothes. You're going to see a range of pretty much everything. You know, people are selling all kinds of things at car boot sales for all kinds of prices. Alright, so I actually didn't end up filming anything at climbing simply because it was so busy. There was loads of people there. I think there was a kids' party and stuff. And we were actually doing a course. We were doing a little sort of lesson thing to learn how to lead climb, which for those of you who don't know is where you put the rope in the rock as you go up instead of being pulled pretty much from the top by a rope. So I learned that and it was too busy to film, so I didn't think I'd film. So anyway, this video, we're just going to sort of divert this a bit and talk about memory. Now, you're probably wondering why I'm standing in front of loads of these random, like, these random stickers, these post-it notes here, is because I'm learning Spanish at the moment, and these are essentially giant flashcards. I basically got a giant, like, post-it note collection thingy, and they all obviously have Spanish words on them. They have, like, for example, the Spanish word, how it's pronounced, the English word, and a picture of it. And then the colour of the post-it note indicates the gender of the thing, whether it's masculine, feminine, or neutral. So why am I telling you about this? Basically, I just wanted to talk about memory in general and how, if you're trying to remember something, if you're trying to learn something, the best thing you can, one of the best things you can do is to actually do something like this. Like, if I'm trying to remember something, I'll put things around my room that I can see that make it more obvious what I'm trying to learn. So yeah, you've got like the different things there, and then at the start I tried to put them sort of around the room in places which would make sense for the actual cards. So like, for example, I would have books like cards like book, library, and to read. I would have these near the actual books, but then there were so many of them that eventually I just decided to, you know, put them all on the cupboard like this. So there's a few here, there's also some over there as well, and there's loads of them. But also on the door, things that make sense for the door: room, exit, door. So yeah, I just thought I'd share this little memory idea with you guys. If you're trying to learn something, put it on post-it notes. You don't have to get a pack like these, you know, it's just because I'm learning Spanish I've got these ones. Put it on post-it notes, stick them around your room in places where you're likely to remember them. This is actually the start of something called a memory palace, which obviously these are all in one place. But what I would do if I had a slightly bigger room, or, you know, if I wanted to put them all around the house, for example, I would actually put the post-it notes in the places which made sense for those words. Say if I'm trying to remember the name, the word for shower, I would maybe put a post-it note above the shower. Or, you know, same for mirror, same for everything else. So you can do loads of stuff with this, guys. But yeah, if you're trying to remember something, put the ideas around the house. I know this has been a very short vlog, but I didn't get to film climbing, so I'll be back tomorrow.